Good day, everyone. My name is Jewel, and this is the Tropical Update. Well, you know what happened, folks? TD11 has turned into Tropical Storm Josephine. Now, we're looking at it on the satellite here, and the imagery is showing that the convection portion is better organized, okay? A little bit better organized. It's got a weak band in the northern semicircle, and it's got a ragged central convection feature. As you can see, all of this is kind of ragged in here, but yet it is still there. Now, over the next several days, this is what should happen. It should move toward a subtropical ridge. Now, this ridge is going to be very weak. So, what does that mean? Additional strengthening is very possible. Looking like winds could get up to 60 miles per hour. Now, this strengthening is likely during probably the next 24 to 36 hours because it will move through light vertical wind shear. But after that, it's going to hit strong southwesterly shear and an upper level trough. Now, this should cause Josephine to weaken. And here's just a little something for thought. Josephine is the earliest 10th tropical storm of record in the Atlantic, with the next earliest 10th storm being Tropical Storm Jose back in 2005. Now, here we're over at the National Hurricane Center, and we have Tropical Storm Josephine. The winds are 45 miles per hour. These are the sustained winds. Pressure 1,005 millibars. It has come down just a slight bit in barometric pressure. Located 13.7 north, 49.2 west. Now, it's moving west-northwest at around 15 miles per hour. Now, as we look at the tracking map from the National Hurricane Center, X marks the spot right in here is where Josephine is as of now. You can see it is going to remain a tropical storm until it gets up past the islands here, north of the islands. You guys should be okay as of now. It could move, though. You need to not let your guard down. Remember, it can move, but I'm thinking this is a pretty good track to go by, more or less like what I said in the very beginning. It should remain a tropical storm, but once it hits that wind and it hits that ridge, it's going to start to disintegrate very, very fast when it starts to make that turn up to the north and just become a big old rainmaker. Let's hope this turns out to prove true. Don't let your guard down, though, if you're living anywhere on the islands here. I'd say from Puerto Rico all the way down. Just keep your information up to date so you know what's happening. We know how these things can change. When we look at the loop for the tropical storm force winds, you can see that over the next period of time, for the next several, 3, 4, 5 days, as Josephine moves along, right in this area up north, as of now for the island areas here, looking like you've got a low chance of some wind. You should maybe get a few wind gusts now and then, but as the worst winds are looking, they're going to stay around the center area of Josephine. Now, of course, this will change as the storm moves day by day, but this is what it's looking like generally as of right now. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. I would appreciate it so much. Click subscribe, click the bell, check off all to make sure you get all the latest information on tropical weather as well as weather in general. I would appreciate it so much, and thank you for all my new subscribers, and God bless each and every one of you, my old subscribers and my new subscribers. I care about you all. I just wanted to put this up from the National Hurricane Center. There are no coastal watches or warnings in effect right now, but all interest in the Leeward Islands, you should monitor the progress of this system, just like I said a few moments ago. As we take a look at the eastern North Pacific, here we have disturbance number one. It's an area, it's still disorganized showers and thunderstorms, and it's associated with a trough of low pressure. It extends several hundred miles southwest of the southwestern coast of Mexico. Now, it's looking like the conditions are conducive for some more development, and a tropical depression is expected to form within the next few days before the system reaches cooler waters later this week. The system is forecast to move west-northwestward at around 10 to 15 miles per hour away from the coast of southwestern Mexico. That's a very good thing. Formation 2 days, 70%. Formation through 5 days is 90%. Now, everybody down in this portion of Mexico, you need to really keep your eyes on this, okay? Because this trough of low pressure has developed just offshore the Pacific coast of Central America. Now, we've been talking about this, and these conditions are expected to be conducive for a low to develop from this trough over the next few days. And a tropical depression is likely to form this weekend or early next week. It's going to move generally west-northwestward offshore right there on the coastline of Mexico. So if you live on that coastline of Mexico, you please be aware of what's going on. Now, the formation in 2 days is low, 10%. But through the next 5 days, it has a 70% chance to intensify very much. And I think this one just might. That's why I'm stressing very much. Everybody who lives on the coast of Mexico there, keep up with it. 5 days, it's 70% chance. Then we have Tropical Depression 10E. The winds are 35 miles per hour. The pressure, 1,004 millibars. If you're tracking, 13.7 north, 129.8 west. It's moving west around 9 miles per hour. And that's a check of the tropical update for today. Everyone have a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day. Do not worry. I will keep everyone abreast for the island areas here of what's going on with Josephine. We all know things can change. This is just what it's looking like as of right now. The winds will probably reach at least 60 miles per hour at its peak. That's a good estimate looking forward to it right now. So be aware, it looks like it's going to bypass all you guys, but we never can tell. So everybody needs to stay abreast and keep up on what's happening with it. Thank you for everything you do for me. Thank you for my donations through PayPal. Thank you for watching my videos, sharing my videos. Anybody down on the island area, Dominican Republic, Puerto Rico, the islands, you guys need to share this information with your family and friends and also on your social media to help me keep people safe and aware. Peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. I love you all. Stay safe, my friends, and thank you for watching.